Good evening, everyone, and welcome. Please stand and join in our opening song, number 305, Gather the People, number 305.
Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit,
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God the Father, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with each one of you.
And with your spirit.
My brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you washed the feet of your disciples. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you gave us the Eucharist as an everlasting memorial of your light and your life. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
And Lord Jesus, you summon us to a table of reconciliation and peace. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Thank you.
Let us pray. O God, who anointed your only begotten Son with the Holy Spirit and made him Christ and Lord, graciously grant that being made sharers in his consecration, we may bear witness to your redemption in the world. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of Exodus. The Lord said to Moses and Aaron in the land of Egypt, "This month shall stand at the head of your calendar. You shall reckon it the first month of the year. Tell the whole community of Israel, on the 10th of this month, every one of your families must procure for itself a lamb, one apiece for each household. If a family is too small for a whole lamb, it shall join the nearest household in procuring one and shall share in the lamb in proportion to the number of persons who partake of it. The lamb must be a year-old male and without blemish. You may take it from either the sheep or the goats. You shall keep it until the 14th day of this month, and then, with the whole assembly of Israel present, it shall be slaughtered during the evening twilight. They shall take some of its blood and apply it to the two doorposts and the lintel of every house in which they partake of the lamb. That same night they shall eat its roasted flesh with unleavened bread and bitter herbs. This is how you are to eat it: with your loins girt, sandals on your feet, and your staff in hand, you shall eat like those who are in flight. It is the Passover of the Lord. For on this same night I will go through Egypt, striking down every firstborn of the land, both man and beast, and executing judgment on all the gods of Egypt, I, the Lord. But the blood will mark the houses where you are. Seeing the blood, I will pass over you. Thus, when I strike the land of Egypt, no destructive blow will come upon you. This day shall be a memorial feast for you, which all your generations shall celebrate with pilgrimage to the Lord as a perpetual institution." The word of the Lord.
The death of
reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, I received from the Lord what I also handed on to you, that the Lord Jesus, on the night he was handed over, took bread, and after he had given thanks, broke it and said, "This is my body that is for you. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same way also the cup, after supper, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood. Do this, as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me." For as often as you eat this bread and drink the cup, you proclaim the death of the Lord until he comes. The word of the Lord.
With you.
With your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Before the feast of Passover, Jesus knew that his hour had come to pass from this world to the Father. He loved his own in the world, and he loved them to the end. The devil had already induced Judas, son of Simon the Iscariot, to hand him over. So during supper, fully aware that the Father had put everything into his power, and that he had come from God and was returning to God, he rose from supper and took off his outer garments. He took a towel and tied it around his waist. Then he poured water into a basin and began to wash the disciples' feet and dry them with the towel around his waist. He came to Simon Peter, who said to him, "Master, are you going to wash my feet?" Jesus answered and said to him, "What I am doing you do not understand now, but you will understand later." Peter said to him, "You will never wash my feet." Jesus answered him, "Unless I wash you, you will have no inheritance with me." Simon Peter said to him, "Master, then not only my feet, but my hands and head as well." Jesus said to him, "Whoever has bathed has no need except to have his feet washed, for he is clean all over. So you are clean, but not all." For he knew who would betray him, and for this reason he said, "Not all of you are clean." So when he had washed their feet and put his garments back on and reclined at table again, he said to them, "Do you realize what I have done for you? You call me teacher and Master, and rightly so, for indeed I am. If I, therefore, the master and teacher, have washed your feet, you ought to wash one another's feet. I have given you a model to follow, so that as I have done for you, you should also do." The Gospel of the Lord. We begin our sacred triduum, the sacred 3 days. Lent is finished with the Mass of the Lord's Supper on Holy Thursday. And when you think about it, our liturgies on these days of Holy Thursday and Good Friday and the Easter Vigil, our liturgies do not end or finish the usual way we have with a final blessing and a dismissal. And our beginning of the liturgy is different, especially on Good Friday when the priest in silence comes into the church, lies down right there on the floor with the first step in silence. In a sense, we have one grand liturgy with the sacred triduum. And this liturgy then is broken into three different parts: the Holy Thursday, Good Friday, and the Easter Vigil. Tuesday evening at the Crucem Mass, the three oils we have at Mass this evening were consecrated by our bishop. These oils are not going to touch every parishioner this year. Some babies will be anointed when they're baptized. Some ill parishioners will be anointed with the oil of the sick. And again, we have the oil, we have anointing of the sick and with the elderly people or those who need extra strength, they're ill. The two main sacraments we remember this evening are the Eucharist and Holy Orders. Our liturgy this evening marks the anniversary of the Eucharist. We remember the Last Supper, and each priest has the anniversary of his own ordination. But on Holy Thursday, it's the anniversary of the sacrament of Holy Orders. These are the main sacraments that mark us as Roman Catholics. We can't think of the Eucharist without thinking of the priesthood. There would be no Eucharist or Mass if there were no priests. And some parishes have to live with this. They've consecrated hosts in their tabernacle, and there's a certain time set aside on a weekend or sometime. The people know when it is, and they come together with perhaps a deacon or an extraordinary minister of the Eucharist, and they have Holy Communion. They have a service in the absence of the priest. Some of you will remember when Father Ken Roswag had an aneurysm and was out of commission for a while, and I was the only priest for St. Francis and St. Rose, and so I reduced the number of Masses on the weekend. We made it work. I also had a parishioner trained and prepared to step in for me if I got sick. That was Dick Hobbykorst. Fortunately, never had to call him. God is good. God kept me healthy during that time. So anyway, my point is we went from 6 Masses between the two parishes, we went to 4 Masses. The Eucharist is the source of our life. You are invited to stay after Mass this evening for some quiet time with our Lord in the Blessed Sacrament. The Blessed Sacrament will be reserved here in the Blessed Virgin altar. We have adoration every week from Monday afternoon until Tuesday morning. Parishioners are here all night. Our 6:30 Mass each weekday morning during Lent had enough people present to take up a collection. The thought did cross my mind. No, just kidding. But anyway, I find it a testimony to the faith in our community that so many people believe in the Eucharist and come to Mass to start their day. It's a great start to the day. Besides the oils and the sacraments of the Eucharist and Holy Orders, we have the washing of feet this evening. It takes place right after the homily. This washing feet is a once-a-year deal and is right out of the Gospel, like you just heard. Jesus washed the feet of the apostles. Washing of feet was common at the time of Jesus, and it was a sign of service. Remember from the Gospel? Peter didn't want Jesus to wash his feet. Peter should wash the feet of Jesus the way he looked at it, but Jesus persuaded Peter to let Jesus wash his feet. We can renew our dedication to serve. Brothers and sisters can serve their younger brothers and sisters by washing their feet symbolically. They can show their love for their younger brothers and sisters, their siblings, by serving them whatever way they can, helping them with their homework, helping with their jobs around the house, their chores on the farm, whatever. Mother and father can wash each other's feet by loving and serving each other and surprising each other by serving when the spouse has not asked for help. Husband or wife sees the need, recognizes their love for their partner, and then steps up to the plate and serves. And families can wash the feet of their parents and grandparents. We can call it love, we can call it respect. See the need and go out of your way to meet it, because that need will pass as time marches on. Don't regret missed opportunities to wash each other's feet. Like I said, now we'll have the washing of the feet, and the ushers would, people that are going to participate, if they would come up and get in place, and the ushers would bring the chairs and so on.
Yeah.
Please rise for our prayers of the faithful. Like the bread and wine that we will offer in the Eucharist, we now offer our prayers and petitions, trusting that God looks with favor on our heartfelt offerings.
For the Church, that priests, strengthened by the Holy Spirit, serve God's people in holiness, love, and joy, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That political leaders and legislators remain aware that they were elected to serve, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who work serving others, especially those who minister to the sick, injured, or dying, are recognized for the value and dignity of the work they do. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all who participate in the Paschal Triduum fulfill the promise of the Eucharist in their everyday lives, loving and serving the Lord in the way we love and serve one another. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all of us here this evening understand the centrality of service in the life of a Christian and embrace the cost of discipleship. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the dignity and sacredness of all human life, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the prayers that we hold in the silence of our hearts. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Ever faithful God, your Son gave us a model to follow when he gave us his body and blood to nourish us, to sustain us, and to save us. Hear our prayers as we celebrate this holy meal through your Son, who is our Passover and our Lord forever and ever.
As the gifts are prepared, please join in singing number 309 here at this table, number 309.
Thank you.
referred to the three oils, and they are going to be presented now. And you have a response when I offer each different oil. And the response you'll have is, blessed be God forever.
Blessed be God forever.
Very good. The oil of the sick. May the sick who are anointed with this oil experience the compassion of Christ and his saving love in body and soul. Blessed be God forever. The oil of the catechumens will now be brought up. Through anointing with this oil, may our catechumens who are preparing to receive the saving waters of baptism be strengthened by Christ to resist the power of Satan and reject evil in all its forms. Blessed. Our final oil is the Holy Chrism. Through anointing with this perfumed chrism, may children and adults who are baptized and confirmed and priests who are ordained experience the gracious gift of the Holy Spirit. Blessed be God forever. I'll have the gifts presented.
Thank you. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. Humble spirit and contrite heart, may we be accepted by you, O Lord. May our sacrifice in your sight wash away my iniquity. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. Grant us, O Lord, we pray, that we may participate worthily in these mysteries. For whenever the memorial of the sacrifice is celebrated, the work of our redemption is accomplished. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lord.
It is right to give him thanks and praise. No, we give thanks to you, O Lord. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For the days of his saving passion and glorious resurrection are approaching, by which the pride of the ancient foe is vanquished, and the mystery of our redemption in Christ is celebrated. Through him, the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim. Most merciful Father, we make humble prayer and petition through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, that you accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which we offer you firstly for your holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world, together with your servant, Francis, our Pope, Thomas John, our Bishop, and all those who, holding to the truth, hand on the Catholic and Apostolic faith. Remember, Lord, your servants and all gathered here, whose faith and devotion are known to you. For them we offer you this sacrifice of praise, or they offer it for themselves and all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls and hope of health and well-being, and paying their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true. In communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious ever-Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew and all your saints, we ask that through their merits and prayers in all things, we may be defended by your protecting help. Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family. Order our days in your peace. Command that we be delivered from eternal damnation and counted among the flock that you have chosen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven, to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took his precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more, giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. As we celebrate the memorial of the Blessed Passion, the resurrection from the dead, and the glorious ascension into heaven of Christ, your Son, our Lord, we, your servants and your holy people, offer to your glorious majesty from the gifts you have given us this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life, and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them as once you were pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel the Just, the sacrifice of Abraham, our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer, we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high, in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who through this participation at the altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son, may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing. Remember also, Lord, your servants who have gone before us with the sign of faith and rest in the sleep of peace. At this point of the Mass, we pray for our deceased relatives, friends, fellow parishioners, benefactors. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace. To us also, your servants, who though sinners, hope in your abundant mercies, graciously grant some share in fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon through Christ our Lord, through whom you continue to make all those good things, O Lord, you sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin, safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Amen. Let's offer each other a sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Join in singing number 339, The Supper of the Lord, number 339.
Thank you. leave it all behind.
Your pursuit of perfection.
Leave it all behind.
Your fear of rejection.
Leave it all behind.
Rusty chains of addiction.
Leave it all behind.
All the guilt that weighs you down.
I have what you need. You keep on searching. I've done all the work. You keep on working. When you're running on empty and you can't find the remedy, just come to the well. You can spend your whole life chasing what's missing. It just ain't gonna listen when nothing can satisfy and the world leaves you high and dry. Just come to the wind. All the thirst will pass no more. All the search will find that there's so strong.
We'll soon take the Blessed Sacrament over to the Blessed Virgin altar, and there we'll stay, and the church will be open till 9:30 tonight for those who want to spend some quiet time with the Lord. continue on with our Triduum. Let us pray. We beseech you, Almighty God, that those you renew by your holy sacraments may merit to become the pleasing fragrance of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. Amen.
To the Father, Son.